Yo guys, this is Reinhardt and this is gonna be a huge nerd analyzing video. There's not gonna be a lot of entertainment, but mostly pure raw statistics and numbers and showing you why resilience is probably the best PvP stat right now out of everything. And for those who are looking for entertainment, this video is not for you. But for those who are looking what stats are right now amazing for PvP and want to see the math backed up to it, stay with it. This video is going to be amazing. I started jamming resilience myself fully on my DK because I get focused a lot and there's been just so much damage going on. And to my surprise that actually every top rated player started jamming resilience no matter what their class is. And what I decided to do is I decided to look into this thing and actually come up with the exact mathematics of collecting the data and showing you guys the exact mitigation you're gonna get from resilience and how much better it actually becomes the more you have it. So let's get started. In this video I'm gonna talk about the benefits of resilience, how it scales, what the actual numbers inside the calculations of resilience and how it's exponentially scaling, and I'm gonna show you the great example of PvP power versus PvP resilience. It's gonna be awesome. For the starters, the resilience is actually exponentially scales, and the more you have it, the better it becomes. So, from 41 to 41%, it's actually a lot smaller bonus to your damage mitigation than from 60 to 61%. So let's jump into the numbers and let's actually see what the numbers represent. So let's say you have an average 200k frost bomb damage on a frozen target, just in general baseline, and I think it's actually a rough estimate and you will see it in the future. And let's say you have a 50% PvP power boost, which is pretty much average for people with a tier 1 weapon and non-human ratio. And let's say with the PvP power boost, the bonus to players jumps from 200k to 300k. And here's where a lot of PvPers get the wrong calculations. And I'm a mathematics nerd, guys. I'm a huge nerd, so I'm ready to pull my hair out of my head because how wrong the calculations usually are. But this is how it works in a general conception. What a lot of people think is they think that your PvP resilience is completely cancelled by your PvP power. So it's like 60% resil minus 50% PvP power. And that's how you get a damage. So for example, for a 200k ability, the calculation what a lot of people think is wrong is equals to your 200k times in parentheses 100% of the damage minus, and in parentheses you cancel resil out of the PvP power. That's how you get to 0.9 and you get 180k damage approximately. I know it's very boring, but follow me right here. This is the wrong calculation and it shouldn't be here. And this is the correct calculation for actual damage mitigation from resilience. It's actually damage ability times PvP power. It's first, it multiplied first, and then that times the 100% minus PvP resil. So in that sense, it's 200k frost bomb times 1.5, means a PvP power multiplier gets up to 300k damage that I talked previously, times 100% minus 60% resil. Basically, whatever left of a damage you're gonna take outside of the resilience. So it's 300k damage times 0.4, which is 40% of the damage you're gonna take. If you have 60% resilience, 100% minus 60% is gonna be 40%, so it's times 0.4 and it's gonna be 120k. And look how actually perfectly it rounded up, because average frost bomb does 120k damage on you, so to say. And this is a brief rough estimate, guys, so it's not including procs and not including a whole other in-depth calculation. I'm trying to make it as easy and as simple to follow. And here's the epiphany of nerd analyzing. This is where I'm gonna be showing you guys how the resilience gets better the more you have it. Let's say you have a baseline resilience of 40%. So then the damage to you will be 1 minus 0.4 equals to 60%. 60% of the entire ability damage that is modified with the PvP power is gonna be coming damage into you. So it's 300k times 0.6 equals to 180k damage. And let's say you're gonna get up to 41% damage mitigation. You get 1 extra percent resilience. And then you're gonna take 177k damage. So the comparison with that 3k is actually not a 1% like a lot of people think it is. It's actually 1% resilience going from 40 to 41% is actually a active 1.666% damage reduction. So 1% of extra resilience will be equal to 1.6% damage reduction. But now let's look at it from a 60% standpoint. Now this is the illustration how resilience get better the more you have it. So let's say, for example, you are sitting at 60% resilience and the damage to you will be only 40%. So 300k times 0.4, you're gonna take 120k damage compared to if you were sitting at 40% resilience, you would have been taking 180k damage. And let's say you go by 1% up. You'll say you go from 60 to 61%. Then the damage you're gonna take will be equals to roughly 39%. So 300k times 0.39 gonna equals to 117k damage. And that 117k damage compared to 120k, you basically gonna reduce damage taken to you by 2.5%. So 1% extra resilience going from 60 to 61 is gonna be 2.5% of active damage mitigation against the players. So these are the rough numbers and show you how exponentially it gets better. So from 40 to 41% resilience, you're gonna get 1.6% damage mitigation, 1.7 approximately. From 60 to 61%, you're gonna get about 2.5% damage mitigation. But here's the funny thing, from 66% to 67%, you're gonna get approximately 3% damage mitigation. And it gets better and better in terms of damage mitigation the more resilience you have. So I'm gonna make a number illustration right now here. What's the resilience versus PvP power of just one simple gem, and what difference does it make, and how it actually scales up? So I have a PvP power gem right now, and I'm sitting at roughly 65.77% resilience mitigation and about 48.73% PvP power. And I got all those numbers. They're gonna be showed up after this clip. And let's say I'm gonna replace one blue gem with one resilience gem. So my PvP resilience is gonna jump up to 66.53%. And my PvP power is gonna go down to 47.52%. So roughly I gained about 0.75% extra resilience mitigation and I lost about 1.19% PvP power. So here are the stats of just one gem making a difference, and it will be actually pretty damn huge. So this is the stats with a 320 PvP power, and this is the stat with a 320 PvP resilience gem. So let's take a look at the actual difference. It's 1.19% less PvP power, but it's 0.75% more resilience. Let's actually make a scenario here really quickly. So let's say two DKs dueling each other, and let's say the average does 100k ability rate damage. This is just a rough estimate, guys. Nothing 100% concise when it comes to ability damage. So the two DKs hit each other with a blitz rate, and DK with the PvP power is actually gonna hit less. He's gonna hit for 49.8k damage, while DK who gen PvP resilience gonna actually hit a little bit harder on the DK with the PvP power for 50.5k damage. And the difference between those two damages is actually funny, that DK who's jamming resilience gonna hit the DK who jams PvP power by 1.42% harder. But of course this is just one gem. Let's look at the scenario where there are multiple gems are. So I took a rank 1, rank 2 non-human warriors, so not to skew my results for the PvP power, and one warrior, Fat Boy, actually gemmed full PvP power, while warrior 2, Hoodrich, actually gemmed full PvP resilience, and this is the stat difference between those two. But let's actually look at the pure raw numbers if they would actually hit each other with heroic strike. So let's put a scenario where they hit each other with a heroic strike, and the warrior 1 Fat Boy will hit on the warrior 2 Hoodrich for roughly about 50,366 damage, while Hoodrich actually, who gems full resilience, gonna hit on the warrior 1 for 58,864 damage. This is where it gets actually very hilarious. When we compare both two numbers damaging each other, if Warrior 2, the guy who actually jams full resilience, will hit harder on the Warrior 1 by 14.44%. The funny thing is, the guy who is jamming full resilience will actually hit harder on the guy who actually jams full PvP power by a good margin. And for classes like DKs, who are getting trained constantly and constantly, jamming fully resilience is actually probably the best way to go to increase your sustainability. Keep in mind that just measly going from 60 to 66%, you will increase your damage mitigation by roughly 15%, and it's way harder than, way better than what the blood presence can actually provide you. Bonus. A lot of people think that actually the opposite, blood presence is stacked multiplicatively. Well, it's actually 100% incorrect. Let's look at the real mathematics of how much actual resilience does blood presence add you. So let's say we have a 10% blood presence mitigation, which is actually going to be 0.9% multiplier. So without the blood presence, you're going to do, let's say, for 100k damage ability, 40k. And with the blood presence, you're going to do 36k. What is the funniest thing is blood presence actually added 4% resilience to your damage mitigation. And if we take, for example, a defensive stance, then the defensive stance is gonna add like 15% resilience to you, not the actual 25% while a lot of people think. In other words, right now at 60% level, extra 6% resilience is actually 50% more effective than a blood presence, so to say. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. This was a very huge nerd analyzing video, but I felt like actually this video could help you guys out with your decisions on what to gem as a DK or as any class pretty much. As a healer, you have to gem resilience. I'm gonna tell you right off the bat. Anyway, thanks everybody for watching, and до свидания, my friends.